ever wanted to play a game without investing in some huge grand scale story? Or you just feel like blowing stuff up in tandem? Sometimes gamers play casual games to warm up the joints before we go in all hardcore. With the feeling of an arcade game, we feel the excitement and childlike joy that we felt from before, but in one cool experience. And with that, welcome to Bodycount, a game with those familiar arcade experiences. In short, you are a single agent working for The Network, an anti-terrorism group stopping threats with the help of a friendly guide. You travel back and forth through new and old territory, saving countries worldwide, until an unknown enemy rears its head out of the shadows unbeknownst to the world lying in secret. Now, you have to stop this unknown enemy with new technology, crazy bases rising up in spires, and it's up to you to destroy them from the inside out.
Code accepted.
An arcade shooter at its fullest. Now, let's see what you got. It's game time! For the bad side of the game, I'm gonna go off script here and really give the lowdown on my personal feelings about the bad, negative side of Bodycount. First of all, enemies are bullet sponges. They take so many bullets to die, even the huge grunts take at least two clips to kill them. Next, unforgiving difficulty spikes. You die constantly, over and over and over again, and it is freaking annoying. Oh my gosh. Next up is fucking machine guns are the best guns in the game. Not pistols, not shotguns. Shotguns even take 4 to 5 shells to kill somebody. And lastly, no health bar. There's so many distractions, explosions, signals, flares, special effects everywhere, constantly going on screen, but there's no health bar. They went for a realistic style of regenerating health, like a Call of Duty style, where your screen turns red, but that's too disorienting when you have fireworks and explosions going off everywhere in your face, and it's annoying. They need a health bar, just like in Black. Have an indicator so I know when I'm about to die in the midst of explosions and gunfire everywhere. It's too confusing. Okay, next up we have the positive side of body count, listing from destructible environments, free motion aim, and or pickups. So, what I'm going to talk about first is destructible environments. You can shred through sheet metal, wood, cover, glass, whatever. Most of the time you are in firefights and your cover will be destroyed, which keeps you as a player moving from cover to cover. Next, we have free motion. Free motion, lean, and aiming, it's kind of like a free flow cover system where you have almost a 360 vertical degree of movement while you're in cover. You can lean from side to side, you can lean, stand up and down while holding the left trigger. And movement is so cool. Let's say if you're on a ledge, you want to lean over to the side and shoot somebody that's below you. That new free motion lean will help you get to areas that most shooters can't. And pretty much the last thing is orb pickups. I think it's a brand new way of picking up ammo and grenades or whatever. It's much appreciated. It stands out more and it looks awesome. And it kind of reminds me of Onimusha. Here's a quick tip. Find yourself a little corner or area to station at. Then build yourself a perimeter for surrounding enemies. Lastly, place down mines to secure the perimeter, and this will be an easy firefight for you. Also, quick tip here. Out of all the power-ups that you should use in the game, use D-pad up, which is the adrenaline power, which basically makes you more durable to incoming attacks. That's the only useful one. Anything else is useless except for situational position, like the airstrike.
So close, yet so far.
That's right, so close, yet so far. Pretty much sums up the overall game's experience and this week's verdict. From intense firefights to crazy spikes in difficulty, Bodycount is a less than stellar arcade experience with some cool aspects, but decent gaming overall. This time, with gameplay, I'm grading it with a C+. With poor enemy balance and AI issues, even with slight potential, this game left us wanting more to desire. Replay value is a grade of low to mid for me. Cool thing about every level in this game, each one is set up like a playground and is adaptable to multiple game types and sessions, but with gameplay, needed a bit more to make this a must replay. And consumer report grade is most likely a rent and borrow from a friend. I wish this game could have a sequel because it does need some fine tuning and more balance to become a really good franchise. Heck, I would even buy a license and add and toss in a 4-player local just to spice it up a bit. Okay guys, that's it for the rundown review, but if you want to see more, go to Alter Element Games, my channel, and don't forget to like and subscribe. Also, here's a list of consoles that I have today, so if you want to see games reviews on these consoles that I have right now, go ahead and drop it in the comments below. And again, thanks for watching, and don't forget to like and subscribe. Alright, peace.
Hold up, you better make a name. Hold your combos, hitting up the chain.